if you've ever looked in the Windows registry, the first thing you would have seen is a list of these things called HKEY classes, root, HKEY local machine, current config, and all that. But what exactly are those? The first thing to understand is that the Windows registry is made up of keys and values. And everything on the left-hand side, they're all keys, but there are subkeys. And then on the right-hand side, when you actually go into something and change one of the variables effectively, that's where you would set the values for any one of the keys. And all of these HKEY things at the top level are predefined root keys, they're called. Now, if you weren't aware, the Windows registry is actually made up of a couple different files on the computer at different locations. So you might assume that these root keys are the names of these files and then everything else is contained within them, but that's not actually the case. The primary location for the registry files are in the C Windows System 32 config directory. And that's where all the files for all the different registry keys are located, except the ones for the current user. That's actually located in the user profile directory, and it's called a .NAT file, whereas these other ones are in the config directory and they don't have a file extension as far as I know. But even in here, you'll notice that these file names don't line up with the predefined root key names. For example, you have files like system, SAM, security, and software, and these actually correspond to subkeys of the HKEY local machine registry keys. So these root keys are not files in themselves. They are basically logical keys that kind of point to a bunch of different stuff that makes up the registry, including these files, and these files happen to be under mostly the local machine key. So you're probably wondering, what are the purposes of these various root keys? And that's what I can go over next. And first of all, if you're wondering what the HKEY stands for, it actually stands for Handle to Registry Key. And further, you may have also seen these root keys abbreviated. For example, HKEY classes root is often abbreviated as HKCR, local machine is HKLM, and so on. The HKEY classes root key mostly has to do with information about registered applications. So it's got things like file associations or which programs open which files. You've got object linking for things called object class IDs and which applications handle certain actions. And how this works is the default settings for these are actually located elsewhere in the HKEY local machine slash software slash classes key. And the user settings, if the user changes it, they would go in the HKEY current user slash software slash classes key. So basically the HKEY classes root will combine those two locations, the one for the default and the one for the user, and turns it into one that the rest of the system will reference. And it basically makes it so the user setting will override the default, and that's the one that gets used. Next is HKEY local machine, and this contains information and settings related to the local computer. So that includes things like system memory or installed hardware or software, configuration data, devices and drivers, and startup control parameters. And you can see this is the case if you look at some of the subkeys in here, such as drivers, hardware, security, software, and system. And actually, if you look at the files in the config directory in System 32, you'll actually notice that a lot of those files actually correspond to subkeys of the HKEY local machine, and that's where they are actually stored. Next up, we have HKEY current config, and kind of like the name suggests, this has info about the current hardware profile of the system. However, if you look closely, you'll notice that this whole root key is actually just linked to the software and system keys of the HKEY local machine key. And also, it's basically just an alias or a copy of HKEY local machine slash system slash current control set slash hardware profiles slash current. Except that it's only going to show keys and values that are different from that default config that is stored there. So in other words, the current config key basically uses part of the local machine key as a template and then builds and changes off of that. Now, next up we have HKEY users, and you could probably guess that this contains settings and information related to each user on the computer. And each user actually is separated into subkeys under here. The default configuration, like for a new user, is stored in config slash default. And unlike the files that are in the System32 config directory for other registry keys, the user's registry keys are actually in that user profile, and it's in a file called ntuser.dat. Next, as for HKEY current user, this just contains information about the current logged in user. And sort of like with the current config to local machine keys, the current user just points to one of the profiles in the HKEY users subkey. So if you look at the contents of HKEY current user, it will contain the same information as one of the profiles in HKEY users, and it will just be whichever one is currently logged in at the moment. Now, there is actually another root key that is not actually visible in the registry editor, and that's called the HKEY performance data root key. This one also doesn't have its own file. It's basically a virtual key, and it basically contains information about the computer's performance, and that would be whatever data is being reported by the kernel of the operating system, drivers, or even some applications. They'll kind of just dump whatever is going on performance-wise into these registry keys. So other applications can read off of that. And you can actually see some of this data in the task manager's performance tab window. A lot of this comes from that registry key. And even though it's more of a virtual registry key, it's not an actual one, it still gets accessed by registry key commands. So you would access this performance data the same you would any other information elsewhere in the registry. So that's kind of why I threw it in there. So all pretty straightforward, I think. Now, if you ever have to go digging into the registry, you'll have a little bit better understanding of what you're actually looking through. If you enjoyed this video, definitely give it a big thumbs up for the YouTube algorithm. This will probably be more of a shorter video, so let me know if you kind of like these more simplified ones. If you want to keep watching, another fun video I have is where I was deleting the Windows registry while Windows was actually running, just as an experiment. So that was pretty fun. You can see what happens by clicking on that right there. So thanks so much for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.